In the Syrian community in New York, they have a synagogue called Shaar HaShamayim. Over there, the Chazanim are experts in makamim. In the back of the Siddur, you'll notice every Shabbat has its own makam. So the tune of the tefillah changes based on what the Torah reading is in that week parasha. The parasha that we sell, the brothers of Yosef sell him as a slave, the tune is a more mellow tune. And when the Jews leave Egypt, it's a more happy tune. Makam Biat is sung whenever a girl is born. And Ben Ish Chai, in his time period, said Makam Biat. How do you spell Biat? And it's Arabic, but we can make a Hebrew thing out of it.
Bet Yud
Aleph Taf. It stands for Bechek Yireh Elohim Tinaten. We pray that she should be given to the arms of a man who fears God. I mean, we're praying already this girl is born, that the person that she marries should be one who fears Hashem. That way she'll, like what Alamam says, if a person wants to torture his daughter, he marries her to an ignoramus. And if he wants his daughter to live a noble life, he marries her to Talmid Chacham. Talmid Chacham doesn't mean someone religious. That's not a Talmid Chacham. Talmid Chacham says it's the opposite of an Am HaAretz. What is an Am HaAretz?
Ignorance.
What do the Chachamim say about an Am HaAretz? Don't read it. It's going to make you very upset. Those of you doing Daf Yomi, when you get the Masechet Pesachim, you read about the tolerance our rabbis had for ignoramuses, you'll be very upset. The Chachamim said, if you give me an Am HaAretz, I'm going to rip his throat like a chicken. And the other Chacham says, like a chicken, I'll rip his throat like a fish. You don't even have to do shlechita properly on a fish. The next one says that I'm going to rip him like a cricket. That way you don't have to salt him before you eat him. This kind of this conversation about Am HaAretz, why? And Am HaAretz are Chachamim viewed as from the worst species on earth. Was the Rambam right? Is Am HaAretz is a person. How does he treat his wife? He's a man who's an evil person. He hits his wife, he beats his wife, he sexually uses his wife, and then he leaves his wife, goes home, goes to work, does whatever he does. He's an Am HaAretz. So what's the definition of Talmid Chacham? The Rambam is defining Talmid Chacham as somebody who's refined, particularly in his relationship with his wife. That's not the definition of a Talmid Chacham that they tell you everywhere else. I mean, Talmid Chachamim shouldn't surprise you then. The Talmidei Chachamim, this is what I'm going to tell you now, it's interesting. Talmidei Chachamim very often did things to ensure the rights of women throughout history, like instituting a ketubah. On the other hand, sometimes they're silent on issues that you might wonder, why are they silent about? And then you realize to yourself, a Talmidei Chacham most likely lived with a woman who didn't feel the oppression that the wife of an Am HaAretz felt. And didn't have to deal with certain realities the wife of an Am HaAretz felt. Today in the morning, I read an article from Rosh Yeshiva. He's alive in America today. A lot of you know his name. And he was asking whether women can teach halakha, people second halakhot. And the footnote he wrote on the bottom there, he said, though not politically correct, everyone fails to address the issue that it is forbidden to teach Torah to a woman on a high enough level that she'll be able to learn halakha properly. So everyone ignores this blatant prohibition of our rabbis against teaching women halakha properly. So how can you ever expect a woman to teach halakha? Meaning, the conversation is moot because women can't learn halakha in the first place deep enough to be able to teach it. That's published in 2020. That's today. Article came out yesterday. Today.
Okay.
We read it. It's a rabbi. I'm sure that many of you even own his books. Now, he's not an evil person. He's simply towing an ideology that's... When I was by the grave of the Piasetz and the Rebbe, his wife actually, it was by her grave. And on her grave, he wrote the tombstone in the middle of the Holocaust. He wrote the tombstone. He engraved. And in there, he writes that she was his chavruta, particularly in matters of Kabbalah and Chassidut. That when it came to matters of Kabbalah and Chassidut, she was his go-to study partner. So obviously the wife of the PSS and the Rebbe didn't need someone to come and liberate her and teach her Torah. She was studying Chassidut with the Rebbe of the Chassidim. But an Am HaAretz is a whole different department. Don't ever make a mistake and fall out on the side of Am HaAretz.